right now, if you go Willis Point, the most of the people is getting evicted. Nobody is getting relocated. Everybody's getting evicted. I don't know how they're going to do it after they evict the business. They're going to bring them back to relocate it. It's supposed to be have a relocation first and make the business and move the people like they did with the Fulton Fish Market. We need and demand the same way to be treated fairly for us.
We're here today on a very important issue regarding the Willis Point development. Behind me are business owners, tenants of the city in Willis Point, and their families who are being disadvantaged by this project. When the city first proposed this idea, one of the things that I said, and I was then a council member, was you must deal fairly with the property owners, the business owners, the tenants, and the workers. That's the American way. We're now years down the road, and the city is still not dealing fairly with these tenants. It is a real disgrace. Now they have offers on the table that if they don't leave by January 31st, they're not gonna get any relocation monies. And there are so many stipulations to this agreement that it makes it virtually impossible for an individual business owner to get some of the relocation monies. This is simply not fair. It's undemocratic for the city of New York to operate this way. And quite frankly, if this was any other type of neighborhood, would this be happening? Behind me, you can see the population is 100% Latino. Is it discrimination? Is it based upon the Latino community being disadvantaged? What's really going on here? So today, I stand with them to call upon the city to give them an extension of this January 31st deadline so that they have more time to relocate, that they have more time to relocate their business, the workers, and treat them fairly so that they can access some of this relocation money. And the stipulations also have to be changed. I'm also here to call for an investigation. I'm going to write a letter to the U.S. Justice Department for the money that's being allocated to Cornerstone, which is the real estate company that the city has paid over $700,000 to help these businesses relocate. Yet today, I think only 10 have been relocated. And I actually did a FOIL request to the city to see what Cornerstone was actually doing. What I got back was simple listings that anybody could get off the internet. So how did the city pick Cornerstone, and what are they doing for $700,000? Because they're certainly not helping the people that are standing behind me. So the city, bottom line is, the city has to do a better job, do a fairer job of dealing with the tenants and the workers.
We demand respect for the working people, for our families, our children, our future. We are Americans too. We demand no more tricks, foolish traps, teasing, Mrs. Yulisa Ferreras, no more lies. The day before yesterday at the board, she says it's 15.5 million to relocate the people, and they are being relocated. That's not true. The people are not being relocated. The people are being evicted. And we don't see the 15.5 million. We don't know where that money comes from. We don't know where is the money.
We're all asking for justice and relocation. Yulisa Ferreras has been saying ever since day one when Willis Point was going to get vacant, she's always been like, we're gonna help you, we're gonna help you get relocated. But where is that help? We need that help now. A lot of us are hardworking people, and everyone deserves justice here, so thank you.
We want to see the city show us money to go in the property and a good plan to relocate us, because by myself and many of us here, not even Cornerstone coming to talk to us, We not even know where we're going.
We don't have a place, we don't have the money, we don't have nowhere we're going. I got family and I need to make money for support my family. So thank you very much. My name is Cristóbal Lara.
En este momento no hemos venido aquí a reunirnos en contra, ¿verdad?, de la ciudad y aquí en contra de la señora Julissa Ferrer, esperando que ella en verdad nos cumpla lo que nos ha cumplido y lo que nos ha prometido, porque en verdad todo ha sido puro engaño y le pedimos que por favor, porque no podemos hacer de que en verdad nos saquen así, que sin darnos nada, entonces hemos ido.
Much as saying that we come over here to call the attention to Julissa Ferreras because she makes a lot of promises and until now we don't got nothing and we cannot leave Willis Pond with nothing.
Entonces estamos esperando porque ya de que estamos justamente que ya nos han llevado para, estamos yéndonos para la corte y estamos ahí con mucha presión y es muy, muy lamentable que todos los negocios, los dueños de los negocios hemos estado con presión y de que desalojemos ese lugar. Entonces nosotros hemos venido en pie de que no vamos a dejarlo desalojar. Aquí unidos vamos a salir venciendo en todo esto.
We are united and we're not gonna leave Willis Point. We're gonna keep fighting and we're not gonna go out with our hands empty. One thing, for the rich people, all of them are relocated. All the landlords, owners, the big guys, all of them are
taken care of.
Yes, they are ready there with money in their pocket. But why not us taking our land to give it to these millionaires? For $1, you think this is fair? You think this is a New York, a century 21, the most civilized city doing this? Not even in the third countries that we come from, they do this.
You know, from the very beginning, this project has been about basically kicking out businesses, 3,000 workers, to give the property to developers. And, you know, they picked the developers, one of which is related. And, you know, this is what the recent mayoral election was all about, making a change in direction in this city, because this project has been about taking away from low-income, middle-income families and workers and giving the money to rich developers. I think the voters of New York City have said, that's not the direction we want to go in. And the new mayor, and I hope he will, and we'll try and set up a discussion with him, will take a serious look at Willis Point development and say, hey, wait a second. If we're going to develop this, let's make sure everybody benefits and that the workers and the business owners are treated fairly.
God bless the new mayor, Bill de Blasio. We put our hope on you. We're waiting for the new mayor to have a good heart for us. Don't discriminate the people in Willis Point and get us a good relocation. I have this message for the community, for the people. Please help us. We are Americans too. Don't let us alone. We all are brothers. Willis Point relocation is necessary for everybody at the city. God bless America. Thank you.
Part of what needs to happen is these businesses trade off of each other. So they need to be in a spot where they can relocate together. Now, part of the stipulation in this relocation agreement that supposedly has been set up is they need to relocate as many as 5 businesses together to qualify for the money. Well, if they're given individual sites by Cornerstone, how can they possibly find 5 sites together? Let's just do the right thing by these people. I mean, it's a simple thing to do. There doesn't seem to be the political will to do it. And the back and forth nonsense has to stop. With one elected official saying something, one agency saying something, the mayor saying something, why doesn't everybody get in the same room with all of these, you know, workers and the business owners and just resolve this once and for all? HPD can do immediately, change their procedure. They can just say, hey, you know what? We're going to give them an extension. They have the power to do that. The HPD is the landlord at this point. The mayor can do it. EDC could probably talk to HPD and the mayor and do it. It's just a simple thing. What we're saying, what they're saying is treat these people fairly. Thank you, everyone.